I've been using bell siphons for a few years in various grow beds. When I went to larger beds, I ran into problems getting the siphon to stop properly. Here is an overview of how I'm setting up the siphons in the new greenhouse, where the problems are, and how I resolved it. This design uses a trap to help start the siphon. When the water level rises, the bell area becomes sealed by blocking the breather tube. As the water level continues to rise, the trap blocks the air from escaping, and the pressure inside the bell is slightly greater than the atmosphere. This pressure keeps pushing against the water in the trap until it pushes enough water out, which burps a few bubbles out. This reduces the internal pressure and the water level inside the bell will quickly rise a bit. This process continues until the water level reaches the standpipe height. The next burp will send a rush of water down the standpipe and the siphon action will start. The air inside the bell is evacuated and the siphon will also draw water through the breather tube. The water level will then start to go down until it gets to the opening of the breather tube. When this happens, a large amount of air enters the bell and stops the siphon. The problem with large grow beds is that the water level goes down very slowly, so when the air enters the breather tube, it doesn't suck quite enough air and the water in the siphon slows down and makes it get stuck in limbo, and it will continue to trickle water out at the same rate that the bed is filling. To solve this problem, I simply placed a little cup under the breather tube. As the water level rises, the cup gets filled with water and sinks, which seals the bell. The bell siphon will operate normally and start up when the grow bed is full. As it drains, the water level will get to the height of the cup. At this point, the breather tube still has water being drawn through it and starts to suck the water out of the cup. This makes the cup buoyant, forcing it to rise. Once all the water is removed from the cup, the breather tube sucks only air, which does a clean break of the siphon. Since the cup is buoyant, it isn't able to flood with water until the water level in the bed starts to rise again. This is a close-up of the cup floating until the water level forces it to sink. This shows the water level in the breather tube and displays how the pressure inside the bell keeps the water level lower than the outside water. With this setup, the top of the standpipe is about 2 inches lower than the external maximum water level. Typically, the entire bell can be underwater before it starts to siphon. Here's the water level getting low enough so the water can no longer fill the cup. The breather tube sucks the water out, making it float. Then it is forced to suck only air, breaking the siphon. Thanks for watching. Please leave a comment below if you tried the floating cup solution, or if you found this video to be helpful. I've added some raw video at the end that shows all the parts I used for my bell siphon assembly. So this is a bulkhead fitting that goes through the bottom of the grow bed. This is a 1¼-inch, it's the only size that I have available. So it threads in this coupling, which then has this reducing bushing to get down to 3/4 inch, since it's the only size, again, the only size bulkhead fitting I have, and then this trap, and then on the top side, again, the coupling, reducing bushing, standpipe, and then the bell siphon that has a 2-inch piece of pipe, a couple spots here for the water to come up in, a cap, and then a 1/4-inch NPT angled fitting that goes to a 3/8-inch tube that's just attached to the side of it like that. The NPT fitting is pretty important. It's nice to have a tap to use to get these fittings on. And then I also put a little ding in the bottom of this breather tube, so eventually that would go over the whole thing like that. And then this little cap goes over this, and that will float up and down as the system runs.